Everybody, welcome back to the Dane Bramage Rocks channel. This is Dane. And to all my subscribers, as always, thank you so much for checking out my content and being loyal subscribers to this channel. And if you're new here and this is the first time you're seeing me or anything on this channel, sit back, relax, enjoy the content. And after this reaction, I will do a wrap up and prompt you to do all the things and welcome you to the channel. But today, I'm going to be doing a reaction to one of my favorite bands of all time, Sabaton. If you do not know who Sabaton is, stick around after this reaction and I will give you a quick introduction of what they are. But I will let you know this now. They are a band that writes songs and makes videos all about war. Okay, they don't have restrictions on which country they choose from. They do battles, they do people, they do like pilots, they do actual conflicts. They're all true stories of battles and wars that were fought throughout history here on the planet. And this song is actually called 1916. So that automatically tells me this takes place right around the World War I era. So this is probably a battle or a song about something that happened in World War I. And again, at the end of this reaction, I will dig into what the song is. I have not actually heard this song yet. I haven't seen the video. It just came out a couple days ago as of the recording of this. So without further ado, let's just go ahead and jump into Sabaton's latest music video released, 1916. I have no idea what to expect, so we're going to do this journey together. All right? Here we go. So before we get started, they have the most phenomenal production values I've ever seen in official music videos. And if you go back through Sabaton's library, you will know this. Or if you already know who they are, you already know this. But I encourage you to go check out their library. You will, number one, learn a ton about different wars and conflicts and stuff that they cover. And just see how passionate they are about singing about the history of the world and the conflicts and, you know, what brought us to where we are today. So some videos are encouraging. Some of you like are enlightened. Some of them are actually very sad because this is, again, this is all real, all true stories. This all happened. So Sabaton, 1916 official music video. This is a long video. You know what I mean? It looks like a movie. It could be watching a movie.
16 years old when I went to the war to fight for a land fit for heroes. God on my side and a gun in my hand, chasing my days down to zero. And I marched and I fought and I bled and I died, and I never did get any older. But I knew at the time that a year in the line was a long enough life for a soldier.
Okay, so did you catch the beginning of that? 16-year-old and I'm already walking the line. I think that's what he said. So this is the reality of this. People have fought and joined wars. It's an even younger than 16-year-old, just depending on what country you fight for. But a 16-year-old already in the midst of combat doesn't even know what life is yet. So this automatically tells me that this is about a young man or maybe a group of young men fighting in a war. Or a battle. So we'll get into that later. There's not, again, the captions aren't on, so I won't be able to actually see what the lyrics are if I happen to miss something. But all right, we already got 16-year-olds and they're already in the middle of this conflict, and this is a slow tempo so far. This might get emotional.
Long enough life for a soldier.
They're so young.
And we added 2 years to our ages. Eager for life and ahead of the game, ready for history's pages. And we brawled and we fought and we fought till we stood 10,000 shoulder to shoulder.
Okay, I heard them say, we signed the dotted line. We marched for our brothers, I think they said, added 2 years to our ages. So they lied about their age. It sounds like they acted like they were 18, unless that was the military's way of getting more people into the combat because they didn't have any more 18-year-olds. So now they're digging into these 16-year-olds and lied about their age to get them to fight the battle or fight for their country. And here we are, 10,000 standing shoulder to shoulder, soldier to shoulder to shoulder there. I'm looking at soldiers and thinking about shoulders. It mixed up my words. But, and you see Sabaton, yeah, their band, they're all sitting there marching. And I'll introduce them if you don't know who they are at, during the wrap up of who, what each person is in this band. But it's almost like a tribute too. So you got the band marching with just people down the street. So there's definitely like a tribute to these kids that were forced to fight in these wars back then in World War One. There, this is what I'm picking up so far.
10,000 shoulder to shoulder. Our thirst for the rum, we were food for the gun,
Food
and
for the
that's
gun.
what you are when you're soldiers.
You're food for the gun, that's what you are when you're soldiers. Motorhead. One of the flags they're holding up is a Motorhead flag. Obviously, the band Motorhead and their lead singer Lemmy is no longer with us, but I wonder if Lemmy or Motorhead did a similar song about this or the kid. I don't know. There's some religion or relation or some tribute to Motorhead. We're going to dig into why that is as well. So now my wrap-up video is going to be pretty detailed, it sounds like. But now notice how they have different cultures even. So it looks like they have a bunch of kids from different battles, maybe all-encompassing World War One there, because it just wasn't one specific group or one specific army. They have all different kinds, all wearing different uniforms. It looks like people from the streets marching with them there. This is how many people it affects. You know, it's just not about the soldier in combat. It's about the family back at home and the people back at home as well, is what I'm gathering from this still. So a lot to dissect here, but I'll keep going because we still got 5 minutes left in this video.
Coughing blood as he screamed for his mother.
I love his voice. Lemmy.
Over 10,000 slain, and now there's nobody remembers our name. Then that's how it is for a soldier.
Oh boy, is this a transition? What is happening? Okay, so that was a cool first tribute piece, right? That is how it is for a soldier. They signed up when they weren't 16 yet. They were literally bullet catchers. They were filling bodies, and kids should not be going out that young. But that was a cool little tribute piece there at the beginning, and I'm still trying to find out why. You saw that they had the picture of the lead singer from Motorhead, Lenny, there that he was carrying. So I got it. We're going to figure out why this all ties together. So we still got a little less than 4 minutes. I'm curious where this is going to go. I wonder if this is just going to pick up and hit to a battle, but this was definitely the soldiers marching out to something. Let's see where this goes. and they disappeared. That's sad. First volunteers with no battlefield experience ran into a hailstorm of machine gun fire at the Battle of Somme. Oh, okay. So this was about a specific battle. They were friends, neighbors, relatives, and workmates from mostly northern communities enlisted with the promise to be able to fight alongside one another. The British Army suffered 57,470 casualties to gain just 3 miles of territory. One man was killed every 4.4 seconds in the largest loss of life suffered by the Army in a single day. Holy cow, that's an awakening right there. And this is all true. 19,000 Englishmen were killed before noon, a whole generation destroyed in 3 hours. Entire towns in northern Lancashire and South Yorkshire had the whole generation of men completely wiped out. Oh, Lenny! Okay. So that was quoted from Lemmy. So he must have... I don't recall Motorsong doing a song about this this battle or these Englishmen. But probably, I think he's from that area, and I might be mistaken, but I'll again, during the wrap up, I'll figure all this out. So Lemmy had, quoted this, and now Sabaton's doing a whole song on it. So yeah, there's definitely, somehow this is related to Lemmy, and I don't know why, but we'll find out. By the end of the battle, casualties from both sides topped 1 million, with more than 300,000 killed for 6 miles of ground. That's the true reality of war right there. Oh, that was the song. Okay, so it was. I apologize. I didn't realize that was a song written by Lemmy or based upon 1960 from them. I do like Motorhead. I'm not too familiar with a lot of their stuff, just probably more of their popular songs. There it is. Answer your own question. Here's the whole band. I thought that was them. I was like, those look like the Motorhead guys, but I wasn't totally sure. Let this play through. Just the end credits. Now I know why this was so long. They had half this song was just credits. Awesome. Okay, so one of the lower tempo songs, and it was written by Lemmy from Motorhead, and they had the other band members there, as you saw in the video, so that was super cool. I did not know that was an original Motorhead song. I don't know if they sang it or not, so I'm going to go dig into that. So, hey, stay tuned for 2 minutes, 2 to 3 minutes. We will do the wrap-up. We'll introduce the band more to you, show you a little bit of their history, and dig in a little bit to what the song meant. All right? Stick around. All right, everybody, what'd you think about that newest release from Sabaton 1916? I had no idea what to expect, and I thought we were going to get like a 7-minute, like complete video of an entire conflict or a war. And I guess half of it was the actual song, which we now know was written by Lemmy from Motorhead, and then the back half was just the credits, but I'm here to watch the whole thing. Leave me a comment below. What'd you think about it? Did you know about Sabaton? Are you a fan of Sabaton, or is this your first time ever hearing from them or about them? And if this is, now I encourage you to go ahead and check out the whole library, because they are phenomenal and you'll love their production values. You'll love what they sing about. They have been doing this for almost 2 decades now, and they have a bunch of albums out. If you just go to the website, which I will leave a link for in this video description, you can go ahead and see all the things they've done, check out all their news stories, go to the YouTube channel, watch all their videos, and listen to their songs, and have a feeling before too long they will also become one of your favorite bands. So what do we know about 1916 now? A lot of it was explained there in the end as I try to read through the credits as they were going through it. But the title track, and this is actually from Motorhead's website, the title track, an uncharacteristically slow ballad in which Lemmy's singing is only lightly accompanied, is a tribute to and a reflection on young soldiers who fell in battle during World War I. In his 2002 memoir, Lemmy reveals that the song was inspired by the Battle of Somme. So speaking of the Battle of Somme, this conflict resulted in a huge loss of human life, as they pointed out in the music video, around 300,000 fatalities. It was one of the bloodiest and deadliest conflicts of World War I and in human history. This is what 1916 was written about, and that's why it is the missing puzzle piece to this EP. Now, that came from Sabaton themselves. That song came from their latest EP, which is called Stories from the Western Front, and that EP is actually part of a trilogy of EPs that Sabaton is releasing, and that whole trilogy is called Echoes of the Great War. So if you don't know who Sabaton is, go to the website, but you have on lead vocals, you have Joaquim, and then the bass guitarist name is Par, and the two guitarists, you have Chris and you have Tommy, and then back there on the drums, you have Hannes. And I'm going to be doing more Sabaton reactions because, again, they're one of my favorite bands. And we'll actually have a special video coming up later in the year, one of my favorite songs they've ever done. But tell me what you thought. Did you like that song? Did you not like that song? Do you know Sabaton? Do you love Sabaton? I appreciate all the comments below. And, hey, now's the time. If you are new to this channel, go ahead and dig around and see what else I have done. And I will prompt you to go ahead and subscribe to this channel. Like this video, hit that little bell for notifications, and share this to anyone you might also think be interested. And again, everybody, thank you so much for checking out this video. Appreciate you stopping by, and until next time, keep on rocking.